In this video, I'll show you how to make a piece of ductwork called a squared around. So we'll start a new part. And we're just going to start with a sketch. I'll choose the top plane. And I'm going to start with a rectangle. Squared around is just a general term for this kind of a shape, so it doesn't mean it has to be a square. And that base is going to be 18 by 10. Now, a couple things you need to do, and one is you got to fill in all the corners if you're going to try to make this out of a piece of sheet metal. So let's put a quarter inch radius on all the corners. You can just window it and it'll fill out all the corners. The other thing is you have to have a gap in this because you're going to try to make it out of a piece of sheet metal. And this is we're looking at the base of this right now. So the easy way to do that is draw a rectangle. Let's put it directly below the midpoint there. And I'll use the trim tool, remove some material. Got carried away there. Trim tool. There we go. And this gap is a gap that's going to need to be welded eventually, so don't make a big giant gap like that. Let's just make a 60 thousandths. And then I'm going to dimension it back to the origin, so come straight down. Make that 30. Finish your sketch, and we're not going to extrude it. We are going to turn on our top plane, and we're going to offset a new plane, and that distance is going to be 18. Oops, not 188. It's going to be 18 inches. And we'll make a new sketch on that plane. In this case, it's going to be circular. And the size of that is going to be 8-inch diameter. And we'll line it up with this here. So I'm just going to put add a relation and click on the origin and click on the center point there and just make sure that they're horizontal. And then I'm going to put a dimension to there, and that's going to be 6 inches. Likewise, we need a gap, so we have to have a gap in this circle part. So use that same technique. Again, put it, I'm going to line it up below my origin there. Use my trim tool. And put some dimensions on that. Same thing, I'll just make a 60,000 gap. And I will dimension it back to the origin. And we're good there. Okay, so we have our two shapes. I'm gonna turn these planes off. And then we'll go up to the sheet metal tab. Now, if you don't see the sheet metal tab, remember just right click in this area here and put a check mark by sheet metal. So under sheet metal, we have something called a lofted bend. You're going to click on that. And now you need to choose the profiles. Choose, like, there's our gap. So choose both of them on the right side of the gap or on the left. So otherwise, you'll get an error. So there to there. And it will form my piece of ductwork. And I can change things. For example, I can change the number of bends that you have on it, so it's going to make it more round. If you get too many, though, it's going to be impossible to make it. Imagine trying to make so many bends on there. So use a reasonable number. And this will be the thickness of your metal. In this case, it's 0.085. And the rest of these numbers you shouldn't have to change. Now, one thing you could change is the manufacturing method. So that's a bent piece of material, and that would be formed, or they would use like a stamping press or something. Typically, you're going to bend something. So, and I'll finish that. It'll take a minute. It's got to do a lot of calculations. And there's our piece of ductwork. And you can see the gap that we left. So after you form it, you would pull it, you would weld it together there. And to finish that out, you typically would weld a flange on top, a flange on bottom, to have your finished piece of ductwork. And we can always go in and change dimensions on this. You'll see this is all the bends, so there's 40 bends on there, but you also see your sketches. So that's the top sketch, bottom sketch. If we right click, edit sketch if we wanted to change something, like change this distance here or change this size here. And it takes a while because it's got to do a lot of calculations. You can create whatever kind of ductwork you want. So basically, if you have one of these patterns, you could make an unlimited number of pieces of ductwork. So imagine a manufacturer that has a CNC laser or a water jet, one file. They could just make pieces of ductwork all day long, super quick and easy. Okay, let's go ahead and save that. And this is called a squared around. Now you can look and see what the flat pattern looks like as long as you're on the sheet metal tab. Click on flatten, and that's what your pattern looks like. You could do lots of things with this. You could, for example, make a DXF file with this and send it to your CNC laser, plasma cutter, water jet cutter. You could even print this out full size, cut it out, trace it on a piece of material if you wanted to cut it out by hand. So lots of uses for this pattern. I'm going to put it back to our shape there. Okay, let's make a drawing out of that now. So what I'm going to have you do is, there's our piece of ductwork, which that's a pretty boring view. That doesn't really do us a lot of good. So what I want you to do is put the pattern, put the flat pattern, and put an ISO on the sheet. And it takes a minute. I've got a fairly powerful computer. It does take a few minutes to do the calculations. There's the flat pattern. And then let's add an ISO view. How about that one? I think I might scale that guy up a little bit. Now again, for the depends on the intended purpose what you want to do. I just want to see that you're able to do this, and that's what I'm going to ask you to turn into me. It's got the flat pattern on it, and it has the ISO view on it.